Ah, Doctor, my child, good to have you back.
Corleone, I have to inform you I found trouble locating those jelly babies that you like so much.
This is devastating. More devastating than the loss of my son.
Unfortunately, there's been a sugar ban on set, so I can't steal those jelly babies for you.
I will take the jelly babies to my grave. I will add new ones to my collection. I took Willy Wonka's chocolate factory. He owed me money, see?
My latest incarnation, the cricket bowling nincompoop, is the one who enforced the sugar ban. We now have to eat that green stick known as celery.
No, I hate celery.
Which is why we need to terminate him.
Okay, Doctor. And when you do, will you locate the jelly babies and bring them to me?
Of course, Your Grace.
Take this, Doctor, and sprinkle it over his celery.
With pleasure.
Oh, and one more thing. When you find Tegan, give this to her.
Okay, but I don't think it'll mean anything coming from me.
Oh, and one more thing, Doctor. Give Turlo this. Doctor, embrace your godfather.
Oh, Corleone, reverse planted my penile float. Would you like a jelly baby?
Right, enough of your dandies and clowns. I'm off to get a sandwich. I might even need this banana as well.
Oh yes, that was indeed a delicious lunch. Really enjoyed that fruit, especially as it came from the 22nd century. Music, maestro! Just let me get my recorder. Seems I was better at playing this when I was on that strange railway with this green number 6 engine, who I just turned up in his trucks with, and then I had to get a bigger number 2 engine that was blue.
Yes, my boy.
Maybe I should try this tune.
With rings on their fingers and bells on their toes, the girls come to Tombstone in their high...
Oh, come on! Ow! Fancy pants.
Enough of this topic, of my boy.
Enough. Enough delicate tunes. Time for some real music.
No, I don't fancy a hike right now, Braveheart.
Tripe!
You can have tripe for lunch, and I'll have my celery.
Giddy-aunt.
Stop gallivanting around and get up, my boy. Just, oh, please, give it. Oh, just give me a moment to catch my breath.
Step aside, chaps. There is only one thing to do. Varum, 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 bally the ayu. Varum, varum, varum.
Stop! Stop this buffoonery at once!
It's the end, but the moment has been prepared for. Now, who wants some candy?
I want candy!
I want candy! I want candy! Hike!
Let's go. The Don has the factory of Willy Wanker. The man who makes jelly babies is dead. We'll make them ourselves. Let's go kill the Don.
Go get him, Bravehearts. It's time for change, my dear.
There is no life I know to compare with pure imagination.
Cease this singing at once, my boy.
Shut the fuck up. Give me the sweets, you ham-fisted bum vendor.
Ah, you inbreds gave me a heart attack.
Inbreds? Heart attack?
The jig is up, Corleone. Give up the sugar.
Never. It has been consumed.
Best hands over, old chap.
Don't want to get diabetes, my boy.
What are you going to do to me, doctor? Shoot me?
I have thought about that, yes, but I've just seen you eat an exploding jelly baby. No one disrespects the jelly babies.
Hello everyone and welcome to a very special Doctor Who review. Today is going to be an interesting review because today I review the 20th anniversary special of Doctor Who, The Five Doctors. Woo! Yeah, this is a big, big Doctor Who story. First of all, before I begin, I would just like to give a couple of massive shout-outs, the first of which to Jack the Film Fanatic for appearing in the sketch of this review. So thank you very much, Jack. And also to Nicholas Payne, who very kindly appeared in the sketch also, but he also lent me the DVD to watch this story. So Nick, thank you very much. I really appreciate it, man. That's very kind. And Jack, also, thank you very much. So let's get on with it, shall we? The Five Doctors. So this is a big story. Basically, I think the best thing to do is to read the synopsis off the back of the DVD. So, if you'll indulge me for a moment. The plot of The Five Doctors is as follows. The Doctor's past incarnations are being snatched out of time and space and transported to the Death Zone on Gallifrey, where they are reunited with some old friends and pitted against their deadliest enemies in the game of Rassilon. Someone is manipulating the Doctor and his companions in order to claim the most ancient and powerful secret of the Time Lords. But can they survive the challenges and uncover the traitor before it is too late? There we go, that is the basic setup of The Five Doctors. You know, The Five Doctors, I would love to just jump in and say that this story is an absolute masterpiece and that it's fantastic and that there's nothing wrong with it, but unfortunately it isn't perfect. What I will say is that it is a very good story. I really enjoyed this story. It's certainly a treat to the eye. I mean, it's hard not to smile at this story. It really is. I mean, you know, you've got five doctors in here. A bit of background, obviously. Tom Baker is kind of in the story, but he's kind of not. They're using footage that they, at the time, it was unused footage of Sharda. So it was technically new footage, but Tom Baker did not want to come back because he had not long left the role. And he just didn't feel like it was right for him. He just kind of distanced himself from the show, and he just felt that it wasn't the right time. He later regretted the decision, But he is not really in the story that much, which is a big problem, which is a real shame, because it is called The Five Doctors, and it does feel like he's severely underused. And, I mean, he's arguably the doctor that everybody wanted to see come back, so... Yeah, I mean, the footage of Sharda obviously is nice and appreciated, and obviously J&T and co. had to do what they could during the time. But I can't deny it does damage the story not having him in it as much. So I wish Tom would have actually come back for the duration of the story. Then it really would have felt much more special. Also, a few other issues. I mean, one of my other issues is the character of Barusa. It just seems strange that Barusa is now a villain. What? I mean, it's just come out of nowhere. I mean, obviously they didn't want to use the Master as, like, the twist villain, because that was too obvious, and they've done that before. I mean, heck, they did that in The King's Demons, and look how that turned out. It just feels like they couldn't think of who to go for. They chose Barusa. Like, it's just weird. Like, he was the Doctor's mentor, you know? I suppose they were trying to go for an emotional plug there, like, to kind of make it more of a shock for the Doctor on an emotional level, but it just, in terms of the script, it doesn't make sense. It comes out of nowhere. Why does this character suddenly have a change of heart? Why does he want to do what he does? It doesn't really make a lot of sense. So some of the script is a little bit hard to follow, I must admit. And Barusa, in terms of who actually plays him, Philip Latham, he does do a good job in the performance of the character. But Barusa in this story, it just feels like kind of a cop-out twist. Like they're like, oh, it's Barusa, oh. You know what, it would have made more sense for it to be the Master, but I suppose that would have been even more of a cop-out. So, my feeling is like, couldn't they have invented a new character? Like, it would have been nice to have a new character, but whatever. It doesn't damage the story too much, but it is a problem for me. They're clearly going all out for this story. I appreciate the effort that everybody's put in. J&T clearly thought, well, this is the anniversary special, we've got to go all out for this. And I do appreciate that, but it does feel like certain characters just don't really need to be here. You even get cameos from Jamie and Zoe, I don't know why, and you get cameos from Liz as well, and I think it's Yates, you know? Like, I mean, they're not the real versions of the characters, they're like these phantom ghost things, but they don't seem necessary to this story. Elizabeth Sladen does come back as Sarah Jane Smith, and I can't deny I'm very happy about that, because she is my favourite companion, but her purpose in the story, again, is not much. They're just kind of bringing back all these people just for the sake of having them there, because it is the anniversary. And I just felt like that it was, you know, she didn't have much to do. And same with Caroline Ford as Susan. I mean, she is great. She is fantastic in the story, and it's great to have her back after all this time. But, I mean, because there's so much going on, it's hard to give each person a big role. And I think the script suffers from being overbearing. There's a bit too much going on, I think, in this story. And in terms of characters, there's just too many people in this story. Have the five doctors, fair enough, but they should have limited the amount of companions that are in the story. This story is actually not aired in four parts. It was aired as one massive long 90-minute special, which is fine. So on the DVD, it feels like a 90-minute film that you're watching, which is great. And it moves along briskly. There's so much going on, because to begin with, we see each of the doctors. We follow each of the doctors in their own separate timelines, and then they get captured, and then they don't all meet until the very end. So that's, you know, obviously the story's building up, and there's various events going and various things, so the editing is intercutting between the doctors, so at times it's a bit hard to keep up. The story's not too complicated, but you're like, oh, okay, so there's the second doctor, there's the third doctor, and there's the fifth doctor. The editing is kind of sporadic. It's sort of all over the place, but it needs to be, because there's so much going on. So I think having a less amount of companions probably would have helped that. But aside that, those are only my only issues with the story. I think the story is great. There's a lot of stakes to it as well, and I like the idea of the death zone on Gallifrey, and the whole thing is like a massive, like, mind game. Like, it's a very intricate kind of situation, should we say. They have to stop Barusa from discovering the most ancient secret of the Time Lords, which is interesting, like when they're all translating the device at the end. I forget what it's called. Again, it's kind of hard to keep up with this story. Performances across the board are fantastic. I mean, I'm not going to go too much into detail, because because there's a lot of people in this story, I'm not going to go through all of them, but Peter Davison, obviously, this is a story in his era. Davison is really good. I mean, he gets a lot of great moments here. Same, it's nice to have John Pertwee and Patrick Troughton back. They are phenomenal together, and it's nice to see that they've still got some banter going on, especially at the end when they say goodbye to each other. It reminded me of the Three Doctors when they first met, which is interesting. Sadly, William Hartnell is not in the story. Well, actually, I say that. There is some archive footage of William Hartnell at the very start of the story, like the speech from Dalek Invasion of Earth when he says, "Oh, one day I shall come back. Yes, I shall come back." That was nice that they included that. To say that he actually has some kind of feature in the story is at least appreciated. But the actor that plays the First Doctor in this story is called Richard Hurndall. And he does a very good job. He does a good impression of William Hartnell. He works well with the other doctors as well. I was surprised, actually. I mean, they've made him look like William Hartnell, of course, but I appreciate his vocal efforts as well. He does a very good impression of him. So they couldn't really do any better, could they? I just feel so sad that Tom Baker doesn't get much of a role here. It really is such a shame. I mean, the footage of Sharda is obviously appreciated. I mean, now it doesn't matter too much because we actually have the full story of Sharda. But I like that at the time they were able to try and incorporate some of that footage of Tom. And even Lalla Ward has some moments there as well. So there's some archive footage which is appreciated. Also, Bessie is back. Woohoo! It's nice to see Bessie come back with John Pertwee as well. I like that when he reunites with Sarah Jane, he actually ties a rope to Bessie and he pulls her up because she falls down a little hill. So that reunion is lovely. That really is nice. Tegan and Turlo. Yes, well, they're the current companions anyway. They don't really get too much to do in this story. I mean, obviously so, because of the amount of doctors we have. Naturally, they were going to get sidelined. Anthony Ainley as the Master. I don't think he was entirely necessary in this story. Like, they want him to help the Doctor for some reason, and I just don't see the need to have him in the story. He just seems kind of, it's kind of one character too many, you know what I mean? That's the problem. The story is overcrowded, and I can't help but thinking they're trying to cram so much into 90 minutes. Even like the enemies, there's a Dalek that appears at the beginning, then there's some Cybermen, then there's these other creatures that disappear here and there. I forget what they're called, but somebody will probably comment down below and let me know what they're called. But there's a bit too many aliens in this story, like especially as like Barusa is supposed to be the central villain of the story. It just feels like there's a bit too much going on, but it's so much fun. That's the thing. Like, you kind of don't mind it because it's just so much fun, and I never was bored. So that's the one thing I can say. Also, Nicholas Courtney returns as the Brig. Again, he doesn't get a lot to do. He mainly sticks with Patrick Troughton in the story. But I like his scenes very much. I mean, we saw him recently in Mordred Undead. So his return isn't as, you know, amazing. But still, it's nice to see him come back for the story. Also, K-9 makes an appearance at the beginning of the story. And John Leeson comes back to do the voice, so that's nice. But obviously, he doesn't feature too much in the main story. So there is a lot going on in The Five Doctors. And the plot is good enough. It's fine for what it is. And as an anniversary special, they have done a good job at commemorating 20 years of Doctor Who. It's a shame it didn't really work out the way they wanted to. But at least what they achieved, I thought, was very good and very solid. And just tremendous amounts of fun. The production design, I think, is also really good. With Gallifrey, and obviously the guards obviously are wearing those red outfits that they had in Arc of Infinity. Like I said, the pace of the story is fine. It moves along briskly for 90 minutes, and it really is just, it's wonderful. You know, it puts a smile on your face, and all of the actors are excellent. It's just a little bit overcrowded. That's the trouble. There's a bit too much going on, and there's too many people in this story, and at times it is a bit hard to follow. So that's my one criticism. But you know what? I will probably give this story, I think I'll give it a 9 out of 10. Yeah, I really like this story. I thought it was a good special. I do prefer the Three Doctors, but the Five Doctors, not bad. Not half bad at all. I mean, it is quite something, and, you know, happy 20th anniversary. Woo! Well, pretty soon it will be the 60th anniversary of Doctor Who, so we'll see what happens there. But, Yeah. This version, obviously, of the DVD contains the original broadcast version and another special edition version. I'm reviewing the original broadcasted version, which is 90 minutes long. So yeah, that's my review of The Five Doctors. What do you think of it? Please comment down below, let me know. Do you agree? Do you disagree? And I want to thank again Nick and Jack for appearing in the sketch, and also for Nick lending me the DVD. Next time, we're going to delve into Peter Davison's third and final season with Warriors of the Deep, which I've heard many things about, but we'll see how that goes. Anyway, thanks very much all for watching, and stay tuned next time. Until next time, I'm Mr. TARDIS 11. See you soon. Bye for now.